today's lecture, we will see some MCQs on our favorite topic, straight line. Let's see first multiple choice question. Here, the point A is given 5 minus 3 and the line is passing through point A and it cuts the x-axis at point B. Obviously, the point B lies on x-axis, so its y-coordinate is 0. So it is something suppose A. So the coordinates of B will be A0 and the slope of line AB is given minus 2. So we know the line which passes through point and its slope. So its equation will be y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. This is the equation of line in slope point form. Here the value of slope m is equal to minus 2 and the line passes through point x1, that is 5 minus 3. So it is y plus 3 equal to minus 2 into x minus 5. So this will be the equation of line, and also this line passes through this point B A0. So these coordinates of B will satisfy this equation. So y equal to 0 and x equal to A, put there. So we get 0 plus 3 equal to minus 2 into x means A minus 5. From that find the value of A, it is 3 equal to minus 2A plus 10. Therefore 2A equal to 10 minus 3, that is 7. Therefore A is equal to 7 by 2. Therefore the second option, 7 by 2, 0, is correct because point lies on x-axis. So its y-coordinate is 0. There are two options having y-coordinate 0, which are B and D. So answer will be either B or D. But by this calculation, we get A equal to 7 by 2. So the option E, D is correct. Let us move towards second example. In second example, if the point 1, 1, here the point 1, 1 lies on the line passing through the points A0 and 0B. Line passes through 1, 1, A0 and 0B. Obviously, A0 lies on x-axis, 0B lies on y-axis. So these are the two points on x-axis and y-axis. So this line like this passes through A0 and 0B. So A is x intercept, B is y intercept. So equation of line will be x upon A plus y upon B equal to 1 in double intercept form. Okay, now this line passes through 1, 0. So this point will satisfy this equation. So we get 1 upon A plus 1 upon B is equal to 1. So our answer is 1 upon A plus 1 upon B, that is equal to 1. So that is the answer. It's very simple. Let us move towards next one. Here, in this example, ABC are given three vertices of triangle ABC and we have to find the equation of median BE. Here, suppose triangle is like this, ABC, and we have to find the equation of median BE. So this E will be the midpoints of A and C. Here A is given, coordinates of A are 1 minus 2 and coordinates of C are 2 minus 5 and coordinates of B are minus 2, 3. So what will be E? E is the midpoint of side AC. So it can be obtained by using midpoint formula. Midpoint formula is 1 plus 2 upon 2 and minus 2 minus 5 upon 2, and it is equivalent to 1 plus 2 is 3 by 2, this is minus 7 by 2, Now we want the equation of B, so by using two points form, we will get the equation of B. Let us find that. X minus x1 formula is upon x1 minus x2 equal to y minus y1 upon y1 minus y. Let us use the values, considering this as x1, y1 and this as x2, y2. So we get x minus x1 is minus 2 means plus 2 upon x1 is minus 2 minus x2 is 3 by 2 is equal to y minus y1. Y1 is 3 upon 3 minus y2 is minus 7 by 2. So it becomes plus 7 by 2. Just simplify, you will get the equation of line median BE. So here we get x plus 2 upon this is minus 4 minus 3, that is minus 7 by 2 equal to y minus 3 upon here is 3 to 6 plus 7, that is 13 by 2. These 2 to get cancelled. So by taking cross multiplication of 13 and 7, we get here 13x plus 26 equal to minus 7 by minus minus plus 21. So equation will be 13x plus 7y. Taking that 21 to the left, we get plus 5 equal to 0. So this is the equation of median BE. And the correct option is option number B. So B is the correct answer here. Okay. Again, there is another way. This point is given. Means if you find the midpoint of side AC, then check whether which equation satisfied by these two coordinates, and that will be the answer. So in that way also you will get option B. Okay, let us move towards the next one, example number 4. The question is here. The equation of line through 1, 2. Here, the equation of line through 1, 2. And which makes equal intercepts on the axis, that we have to find here. So the equation of line which passes through 1, 2 and which makes equal intercepts. Obviously, here equal intercepts are given. So we will use here the equation of line in double intercept form. And here, the intercepts are equal. These two intercepts are same. And the line passes through 1, 2. Whenever line makes equal intercepts, its equation or that line will be either like this or like this. Means making angle either 45 or 135. So its slope will be either 1 or minus 1. So slope of line will be either plus 1 or minus 1. Remember this point. Here, both A and B are equal. So can we change here this B by A? Obviously, intercepts are same. So, write instead of B, A. And put these coordinates because line passes through 1 and 2. So, it will satisfy this equation. These coordinates will satisfy this equation. Put value of x equal to 1 and value of y equal to 2. So, we get 1 upon A plus 2 upon A equal to 1. So, we get here denominator is same. So, 3 upon A equal to 1 implies A equal to 3. So, the intercept will be 3. In our this question, options A equal to 3 is not given, but the correct answer is A equal to 3. Okay, let us move towards next one. So the equation of line will be x plus y is equal to 3. Here this point 1, 2 satisfies this equation, so 1 plus 2, that is equal to. Let us move towards the next example number 5. See this example number 5. In this example, the line KX plus 4Y equal to 6 passes through the point of intersection of these two lines, which are 2x plus 3y equal to 4 and 3x plus 4y equal to 5. Then we have to find the value of k. As this line passes through the point of intersection of these two lines, so just find the point of intersection of these two lines and put the values of x and y, those here, so that you will get the value of k. So we will solve the equation, these two equations, multiply this equation by 3, we get 6x plus 9y equal to 12. Multiplying this equation by 2, we get 6x plus 8y equal to 10. Is it okay? We have made here x coefficient same. So subtracting these two, this line from that, we get 9 minus 8, that is y equal to 2. Putting y equal to 2 either in this equation or this equation, we get 2x equal to y equal to 2, so 6, 4 minus 6, that is a minus 2, implies x equal to minus 1. So x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 2, these are the coordinates of point of intersection of these two lines. Put those here, so this equation leads to k into minus 1 plus 4 into 2 equal to 6. So this is minus k plus 8 equal to 6, so k is equal to 2. So the correct answer is k equal to 2, that is option number B. B is the option having answer k equal to 2. So this is again very simple example. One unknown k is asked here. Okay, let us move towards next one, example number 6. Here the equation of line, the example is given, the equation of line having inclination of 120 with positive direction of x-axis, which is at a distance of 3 units from the origin is. Now just we'll draw your rough sketch. The inclination of line is 120, so this will be suppose 120, and the line is at a distance of 3 units from the origin. So here inclination of this line is given. Can we find this angle alpha, which is the inclination of normal, because here the inclination of line is given 120 from, but 120 is the external angle of this triangle, suppose AOB, then this angle 90 plus alpha is equal to 120. So can we write alpha plus 90 is equal to 120, therefore alpha is equal to 30 degree. So your inclination of normal is equal to 30 degree. You know the normal form, that is cos alpha x plus sin alpha y is equal to p. So from this can we write the equation of line. So cos alpha, that is cos 30 into x plus sin alpha means sin 30 into y is equal to p is given 3. So cos 30, that is equal to root 3 upon 2x, sin 30 is half y equal to 3. Here denominator is same, so we get here root 3x plus y is equal to 3 into 2, that is 6. So the answer is, taking this 6 to the negative side, left hand side, we get root 3x plus y equal to 6. Now here in option there are two signs for this plus y. Why? Because there is another line making the angle 120 here having inclination 120 and at a distance of 3 units once again. But from this answer we can determine our example number 7. A line passes through the point 2 2. This line passes through point, suppose A, 2 2, and it is perpendicular to the line 3x plus 1 equal to 3. And then find the y-intercept of that line. Here point line passes through point A22 and it is perpendicular to this. From this given line, we can find slope m is equal to minus 3. 3 upon 1 its negative is minus. So the required line is perpendicular to this. So the slope of perpendicular line is equal to its reciprocal, negative reciprocal is 1 by. So the this is the slope of required line and it passes through 2, 2. So its equation is by using slope intercept form, slope point form. It is y minus 2 equal to slope is 1/3 into x minus 2. Just simplify this, we will get 3y minus 6 equal to x minus 2. Therefore, x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0. After simplification, we get this. So it's y intercept. We want here y intercept. So y intercept will be, therefore, write this line in double intercept form. So it is x upon 4, taking this minus 4 to the left, becomes plus y upon 4 by 3 equal to 1. So this will be its y-intercept. So y-intercept will be 4 by 3. So the correct answer is option number D. Is it okay? Here, line passes through point A, 2, 2, and it is perpendicular to this line. So its slope is m equal to minus 2. Slope of perpendicular line to this line is 1/3. So it will be the slope of required line, which passes through point 2, 2. After simplification, we get this equation, right, just in double intercept form. From that, we get y-intercept. Otherwise, from this equation also, we can find y-intercept. That is 3y is equal to x plus 4. So y equal to 1/3 x plus 4/3. And this 4/3 is nothing but the y-intercept. This is slope and this is y-intercept. Y is equal to mx plus c. This line is equivalent to this. Y equal to mx plus c. So 4/3 is the y-intercept. That will be the example number 7. Let us move towards example number 8. The example is displayed on our board. Read it carefully. What is given here? Here, the angle between the lines is asked. First line is root 3 x minus y minus 2 equal to 0 is given, and the second line is given x minus root 3 y plus 1 equal to 0. And the question is to find the angle between these two lines. Let us from this line first find the slope of line. It will be root 3 upon minus 1, its negative is plus 1. And the slope of this line m2 is equal to 1 upon minus root 3, its negative is plus 1 upon root 3. So these are the slopes of two lines. You know theta is the angle between them. Then tan theta is equal to modulus of m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m2, and it is equal to mod of m1 is root 3 minus this is plus whole divided by 1 plus m1 m2, that is root 3 into 1 upon root 3, that is equal. Here is root 3, 3 minus 1, that is 2. So it is 2 upon root 3 whole divided by, this is 1 plus root 3 get cancelled. So 1 plus 1, 2. So this 2, 2 also get cancelled. So answer will be 1 upon root 3. So tan theta is equal to 1 upon root 3. So theta will be, therefore, tan theta equal to 1 upon root 3. So theta will be equal to, obviously, we know that tan 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3, which implies theta is equal to 30 degrees. That will be the option number 2. So the answer of this question is option number D, having answer 30 degrees. Is it okay? Let us start with next one. example number 8. These are very simple examples. Example number 8. Sorry, 9. If kx plus 2y minus 1 equal to 0 and 6x minus 4y plus 2 equal to 0. These are identical lines. Then determine the value of k. This k is unknown here, that we have to find in this objective question. Obviously, as these two lines are identical, means obviously coefficient of x should be same, coefficient of y should be same, and constant should be same. If you observe carefully, then this 2y and 4y, this minus 4y can be easily converted into 2y. That's why we will divide this equation by minus 2. So dividing this by minus 2, you get plus 2. So 6x minus 4y plus 2 equal to 0 divided by minus 2 divided by minus 2. Therefore, this will leave us minus 3x plus 2y minus 1 equal to 0. If you observe now this equation, then 2y minus 1, these two terms are identical. So x should be equal to minus 3x should be equal to kx. So the value of k is equal to minus 3. It's very simple. So the first option A is correct here. That is the value of k equal to minus 3. Let us move towards the next 10th example number 10. Find the distance between two parallel lines. The lines are given in this example. The equations of lines are y equal to 2x plus 7 and y equal to 2x plus 1. Very simple equations are given here. Let us rewrite these equations as in general form, that is 2x minus y plus 7 equal to 0 and 2x minus y plus 5 equal to 0. Here the coefficients of x and y are same, so no need to change the equations, and so this will give us first constant c1, and this is our second constant c2. You know the perpendicular distance between two parallel lines. Obviously, the distance between two parallel lines is always perpendicular. It is equal to mod of c1 minus c2 upon root a square plus b square. Okay, so here is c1 is 7, mod of 7, c2 is 5, upon root, coefficient of x is 2, coefficient of y is 1, so it is 2 square plus minus 1 square, and it is equal to mod of 2 upon this is 4 plus 1, 5, that is root 5. So answer will be 2 upon root 5, that is our option number D. So this 10th example is also within single step, it can be obtained the solution of this example. Now let us see different examples than this. Here, first one is the next example number 11 is displayed here. Read it carefully. Here, the points A0, 0, B, the points A0, 0, B, and the third point is given 3A minus 2B. These three points are given, and we have to determine whether these three points are collinear, non-collinear, or vertices of triangle, or none of these. So, for checking collinearity and non-collinearity, we have to determine the slopes of line obtained by taking points AB and BC or AC. We will check first two options. For that, we will find the slopes. So, slope of AB, it is equal to the difference between y coordinates. Here y coordinates are 0 and b, so we can write b minus 0, means we are subtracting this in this way. So difference in x coordinate is 0 minus a, So slope will be b upon minus a, that is minus b upon a. Then slope of line, you can take either AC or BC. I will take AC. It is equal. AC means difference in y coordinate, that is 0 minus this, that is 0 plus 2b upon a minus this, that is a minus 3a, equal to 2b upon minus 2a. You have to get cancelled. Answer is once again minus b upon a. So the slope of AB is equal to slope of AC. Therefore, points A, B, C are collinear. So option number A is the correct option. Okay. Let us see next one. Find the angle between the lines. Let us see next one. Read the example which is displayed on your board carefully. Once again, what is the question? Here, find the angle between the two lines whose equations are given, y equal to x plus 6, and the second line is y is equal to root 3x plus 7. So these two equations are given and we have to find the angle between these two lines. Easily we can find here slope of this line. Let us say it as m1, it is equal to 1, because both these lines are in slope intercept form. So this m will be the slope here. So slope of first line is 1 and the slope of line second is m2, that is root 3. So let theta be the acute angle between these two lines, then tan theta is equal to mod of m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 m. So it is equal to m1 is 1, so we get 1 minus root 3 upon 1 plus m1 into m2, that is product of these two will be root 3, so it is 1 plus root 3. So now it is difficult to determine the angle theta easily, but we know that tan of, because the answer is not 30 or 45 or 60, we have to check whether it is different from that, because here 1 tan 45 is equal to 1 and tan 60 is equal to root 3. So if you find here tan of 15 degree, then it will be tan 45 minus 30. Okay, tan 45 minus 30. So it is equal to, by tan of A minus B, it is tan A, that is tan 45 minus tan B upon 1 plus tan 45 into tan 30. Let us simplify this. Tan 45 is 1, tan 30 is, you know, tan 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3, whole divided by 1 plus tan 45 is 1, tan 30 is again 1 upon root 3. So making denominator same here, you get root 3 minus 1 upon root 3, whole divided by root 3. Here also root 3 plus 1 upon root 3. So root 3, root 3, round 3 is cancelled. We get root 3 minus 1 upon root 3 plus 1. It is very much similar to this. Here is modulus. So we can write this as also root 3 minus 1 upon 1 plus root 3. So both these are correct. So angle will be 50. If this, by this calculation, these two answers do not match, then the answer will be obviously the last option, that is 75, because options are given here 15, 30, 45 and 75. If 15 is not correct, then the answer will be 75 degree. Okay, so this is the way to find the answer of such question. Let us see next one. Here in this next question, The two lines are given which are perpendicular to each other. It's very simple to find the answer because the equations of lines are given. X plus 4y minus 5. X plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. This is one equation of time. And second one is 4x plus k1 plus 7 equal to 0. Here the two lines are perpendicular to each other. So you know the two lines are perpendicular to each other. If suppose m1 is the slope of this line, m2 is slope of these two lines. If two lines are perpendicular, then the product of their slopes is minus 1. So the slope of this line will be, by observation you can write it, it is minus 1 by 4. Slope of this line m2 is equal to minus 4 by k. Now take the product of these two slopes, that is equal to minus 1 by 4 into minus 4 by k, and it is equal to minus 1. So this is negative, negative, positive. 4, 4 get cancelled, it means only 1 by k is equal to minus 1. Therefore k is equal to minus 1. That is the option number C. Third option is correct here. So this is again very simple and short example. Let us move towards the next one. Let us see example number 14. Read carefully. Here, very simple example once again given. The two lines 7x plus 3y plus 9 equal to 0 and y equal to kx plus 7, and the second line is y is equal to kx plus 7. These two lines are given parallel. This line is parallel to this one. Then we have to find the unknown k once again. Find the slope of this line and slope of these two lines, equal their slopes. So slope of this line is m1, it is equal to minus of 7 by 3, and the slope of this line is m2, that is k directly because it is in slope intercept form. So here l1 is parallel to l2, which implies m1 is equal to m2. So minus 7 by 3 is equal to k, that is k is equal to minus 7 by 3. It's very, very, very simple. So option number second is correct here. 4, 6, and it is parallel to the equation of line, that is 3x minus 7y plus 2 equal to 0. Again, we will use the same formula, that the slope of parallel to this line is x slope. Slope of this line will be, by observation we can write 3 by minus 7, x integral is plus 3 by 7. So equation of line will be y minus y1 because point is given and slope is known. So m into x minus x1. So answer will be y minus 6 equal to slope is 3 by 7 into x minus 4. Also you can verify easily by observation that the x and y coefficients of answer, equation of answer will be the same, and that equation must be satisfied by coordinates 4, 6. Here we get 7y minus 42 equal to 3x minus 12. Therefore 3x minus 7y equal to plus 30 equal to 0. Taking all these two terms to the right, we get here this x, 7, 3x, this 7x becomes negative, and plus 42 minus 12, that is 30. So 3x minus 7y plus 30 is equal to 0. So answer number A is correct here. So this is the example number 15. Now let us see one more. That is, this example is different from these previous examples. X plus 1 plus 1 equal to 0. The second line is 2x minus y equal to 0. And third line given here is x plus 2y. Plus lambda equal to 0, and these three lines are concurrent. Whenever three lines are concurrent, the equations are said to be consistent. Okay. These three equations are said to be consistent and lines are said to be concurrent. And whenever three equations are consistent or lines are concurrent, the determinant of coefficients of x, y, x and y and with constants is 0. That means your determinant of 1, 1, 1, 2, minus 1, 0 and 1, 2, lambda. These determinants should be 0. So we can easily find the value of lambda from this equation. Let us find the value of determinant. Here is 1 into minus lambda minus 0 minus 1 into 2 lambda minus 0 plus 1 into 4 plus 1 equal to 0. So we get here minus lambda. Here we get minus 2 lambda and we get here plus 5 equal to 0. So it is minus 3 lambda plus 5 equal to 0. So lambda is equal to 5 upon 3.